Hello students, today again I'll continue with group 16. Today I'll continue with the chemical properties. Actually I'll start with the chemical properties of group 16 elements today. So first is hydrides or the formation of hydrides. The hydrides of group 16 are H2O, H2S, H2SE, H2PE and H2BE. Here in the reactivity of the hydrides, you will see that H2PO or the hydride with polonium is not mentioned in all the properties, because polonium is basically a radioactive element. So polonium this hydride of polonium is not used in all the properties here. So basically the hydrides of group 16 elements are all covalent in nature. That is, the bond between hydrogen and the central metal atom, this group 16 elements here are central metal atom. They are, sorry, not metal, central atom. Really sorry for using the word metal. Do not use the word metal, because they all are non-metals. We all know that group 16 elements are non-metals. But the group 16 elements here are known as central atoms. Okay? Now I'll start with the various properties of the hydrides. First among it is the stability of the hydrides. These orders are important, and the reason behind these orders is also important. First is stability. Okay, now remember one thing, that hydrogen is a small atom, very small atom in fact. So we all have said earlier that they form covalent bonds with the group 16 elements. So if the size of the group 16 elements is large, then there won't be a proper overlap between the orbitals of group 16 elements and that of hydrogen, because there will be a mismatch of orbitals. The orbitals for better overlap has to match with each other. But if the size of the central atom, or if the size of the group 16 elements here is too large, then the orbitals will not properly overlap with the smaller orbitals of hydrogen. So if there is a mismatch of orbital, then the overlap will not be proper. As a result, that will lead to the weak covalent bonding between the hydrogen and the central atom. So in case of oxygen, I'm just showing this, the overlap in this way. I'm not using the p orbital, s orbital. I'm not using all those complicated portions here, because here you just need to know that the overlap is a proper overlap due to proper match of orbitals. Only this you have to know. So I'm just showing this for your benefit or your better understanding. Okay, so see, hydrogen is a small atom, we all know. Oxygen size is also small, because it is in period 2. So the overlap of the orbitals of oxygen with that of hydrogen will be better as compared to the other elements. We all know that down the group size, atomic radii increases. We all know. So oxygen, among group 16 elements, oxygen has the smallest size, and as we move from oxygen to selenium, tellurium, polonium, the size continuously increases. So the smallest size of oxygen will have a better overlap with that of hydrogen. So the HO bond in water will be the strongest covalent bond. Whereas on moving down the group, the size of tellurium is huge and that of hydrogen is small. So the overlap will not be a good overlap, poor overlap due to mismatch of orbitals. So the H-TE bond will be weaker covalent bond. So for when in a compound you have the strongest covalent bond, the stability of that molecule will be the highest. And in the molecule where you are having the weakest covalent bond, the molecule will not be that stable as the molecule having the strongest covalent bond. So the stability order will be water will have the highest stability and the stability will decrease as we move down the group. The stability will decrease as we move down the group due to the poor overlap of the orbitals due to the bigger size of the central atom. Okay, this is all about the stability. Now, another thing here is important that the compounds which are less stable, that is when we are moving down the group, H2TE is the least stable, or H2PO will be the least stable. So on moving down the group, the stability decreases. So the compounds whose stability is less, it can easily give up hydrogen, or the bond between hydrogen and the central atom is weak, so it can break easily. That means that hydride can easily give up hydrogen. So giving up hydrogen means it can act as good reducing agents. So on moving down the group, the reducing property of the hydrides also increases. Okay, now I'll come to the next property, which is acidic strength. So just look at the hydrides. In first dissociation, the hydrides of group 16 are weak dibasic acids. Now, how will you explain the trend, acidic trend of the hydrides in group 16? Now, before only, I have told you that as we move down the group, the stability of the hydrides decreases because of the poor overlap of the small hydrogen atom with the large atoms on moving down the group. Okay, so as we move down the group due to poor overlap, the distance between the hydrogen atom and the nucleus of the central atom increases. In case of water, the distance between hydrogen and the nucleus of oxygen is closest because of a better overlap between orbitals of hydrogen and oxygen. So this covalent bond is the strongest and the distance between hydrogen atom and the nucleus of oxygen atom is closest. So here oxygen will not easily leave the hydrogen. For greater acidic strength or for being a better acid, you have to readily give up proton or readily give up H+, means water has to readily dissociate to form 2H+ and O2-, like this. But for that, for being acidic, you have to give up proton. But if the bond between the central atom and hydrogen is strong, then that central atom will not readily give up the proton. But in case of tellurium, the distance between hydrogen and the nucleus of tellurium is huge because this covalent bond is not strong. So tellurium can easily give up the hydrogen. That is, tellurium will easily ionize, forming H plus. So as we move down the group, the acidic strength increases. Because as we move down the group, the covalent bond between the central atom and hydrogen is not strong. So the central atom can easily give up the hydrogen, or you can say for acid, they can easily, that bond can be easily ionized, forming H plus ions readily. So as we move down the group, the acidic strength increases. And the third property, which is the last property in this video, for this video only, is volatility. And there is an important part, or you can say an interesting portion is present here. You will see that the volatility suddenly increases from, or abruptly increases from, water to H2S, but again decreases as we move down the group. Now what happens in case of water, due to which its volatility decreases? Water forms intramolecular hydrogen bonding with other water molecules. Now why only water forms intermolecular hydrogen bonding? Intermolecular means one molecule will form hydrogen bonding with the other molecule. That means intermolecular. So water forms intermolecular hydrogen bonding. Association of water molecules with each other takes place. As a result, this association, to break this association, a huge amount of heat is required. So the volatility is less in case of water. Now why intermolecular hydrogen bonding takes place in water? Because of the polarity of the HO bonds. Why? Because there is a huge electron, oxygen is highly electronegative. There is a huge electronegativity difference between hydrogen and oxygen. So the HO bond is highly polar and the charge separation takes place well. So there is intermolecular hydrogen bonding present in water only. And due to this, to break this association, huge amount of heat is required. So volatility of water is the least. And again, in case of H2S, H2AC, H2TE, there is no intermolecular hydrogen bonding. So the volatility abruptly increases from water to H2S. Okay, now why again the volatility decreases from H2S to H2TE? This is because on moving down the group, the molecular weight increases. Means the molecular weight of H2S is less than that of H2AC, because the size of H2AC is more, so its weight will be more. So the molecular weight decreases from H2S to H2AC to H2TE. So since the molecular weight increases from H2S to H2AC to H2TE, with increase in the molecular weight, the van der Waals force also increases, because we all know that the van der Waals force increases with the increase in size of the compounds. So on increasing the molecular weight down the group, the van der Waals force increases. And with the increase in the van der Waals force, the breaking off, or you can say the on heating, the molecules do not vaporize easily. More the van der Waals force, less will be the volatility. So from H2S to H2TE, the volatility again decreases. So this is the trend of volatility. In the next video, I'll continue with the structure of the hydrides, and then I'll go to the monohalides. Halides are also important. The structures of the halides are important. So after this video, I'll continue with the structure of the hydrides, and then I'll continue with the monohalides. Thank you.